Men, this one's for you. Hi, my name is Raina. Welcome to my channel if you are new, and welcome back if you've been here before. Today marks episode 3 of our 4-part February Love Local series, and this is just a series where I share with you guys some of the local brands that I'm loving, some of the local brands that you're loving, and some of the local brands that can ultimately use a little bit more love. And in today's episode, we are covering men's fashion. I'm excited to get into this video. It was one that was requested by some of my friends and followers, and so let's get into it, guys. I'm gonna be dividing this video up into kind of 3 categories. So we're gonna start with streetwear, then we're gonna head over to basics, business casual brands, and then we're gonna head over to accessories and like add-ons. And so for those of you who are interested in streetwear, I wanted to just kind of take a moment to define that a little bit. So streetwear refers to comfortable casual clothing, and it usually has ties to pop culture, and so is geared towards skateboard fans and hip-hop fans and those who live in urban areas. Now for you streetwear lovers, the first Montreal streetwear brand that I want to introduce to you guys is one called Heure de Sieste, and it was started here in Montreal in 2017 and was actually inspired by hand-drawn designs, which I think is pretty cool. And I think that when you see the design, especially of the first collection, you'll get that kind of authentic sense that this is a design that's like unique to Heure de Sieste. And I think that when you're starting off, it's so important to have something like that where people can look at it and automatically know that that belongs to your brand. So that's pretty cool. And recently they've also introduced a new collection called Forest Capsule, and they have in it a hoodie and a mug and a tote bag. And so definitely go check them out. The hoodie is around $55. And I think their items kind of range from 28 to the 50s. And right now though, they have a sale on some of their t-shirts. And so instead of being 28, they are $14. And so definitely go check them out. I actually have a coupon code for those of you who do want to check out some of their items, and it is Raina15. And with that, you will get 15% off your online purchase. The next streetwear brand that I want to talk to you guys about is one called Ace Wolf. And they have, again, similar to Heure de Sieste, they have some t-shirts and hoodies. And one of the things that's really cool is that they also have a program where they help to kind of develop the skills of other, what they coin as like underdogs. So people on the up and up in terms of their athletic careers. And so that's something that's really awesome. Of course, it's available to you if you are in Toronto. But I have one of their pink hoodies, and I actually feature it in my summer lookbook number 2 called Life on the Edge. So definitely go check that out. But I think that it's so comfortable, and I think that it's just a really great brand with a really great message. And so if you're interested in checking out more about them, follow them on Instagram, check out their website, and definitely support them. Now, speaking to the skateboard aspect of streetwear, this next company is one called Dime, and it was created in 2005 by skateboarders, and it is definitely a little bit more expensive than some of the brands that I've spoken about thus far. And so they have their clothing kind of more in the hundreds, but again, some really cool basics, and they have their logo Dime that's usually kind of focal in their t-shirts and hoodies and crew necks and things like that. And they've also added some winter coats and some hats, and it's a really, really cool brand. And one of the things that I also want to say as I'm speaking about these clothing brands is that when we are shopping locally, you'll have to understand that the prices will often be a little bit more expensive, especially because if it's made here, then you know, cost and production and all of those things go up, and so that's one of the things to be mindful about. But oftentimes these items are also made a lot more durable than some of the fast fashion items that you will be used to wearing and purchasing. So I would say definitely a worthy investment, especially because, as you know, you are investing in local business and helping to further that. The last streetwear brand is one called Atelier New Regime, and they have a Montreal location and it is sick. And they have this just really awesome orange, which is very unique and distinct in regards to their brand. It is, of course, a lot more expensive than the ones that I previously shared with you guys, but their designs are just sick. Like, they're really, really cool. And so if this is, you know, within your budget and is a local company that you can find yourself in investing in their pieces and supporting, then I highly recommend. I've had this hat for years on years and it still looks amazing. I like that it has this kind of leather strap here, which is really, really nice. So yeah, I would highly recommend Atelier New Regime, but again, it is definitely on the expensive side. But just like anything, they have sales, so it's just about knowing when those are. Next up, we are gonna be covering business casual and basics, which really just refers to items that are less formal than traditional business wear. So, you know, not suits and all these different things, but you can still find your button downs, you can still find your trousers, and you can still find ties and sweaters and things that allow you to show up to the office or different events in a way that is maybe a little bit more professional, but not formal necessarily. And so the first one that I want to talk about is a company called RW & Co. And it can kind of teeter on the more formal side if you need, because they do have some suits and things like that. But this is a Montreal designed company and they really pride themselves on things like sustainability and making sure that their practices are in keeping with their values. One of the things that's really cool that I learned about them is that they give some of their, or donate some of their designs to design schools so that they can learn about the different do's and don'ts of their own designs. And so, like, instead of just, you know, messing up on a garment and then throwing it away, they donate them to those schools so that students can learn about bettering their own practices, which is great. So they use biodenim, recycled wool, recycled polyester, which is something that is important to them, especially because they are a brand that wants to be and tries to be sustainably conscious. So it's great, and their items are gorgeous. Like, they have really nice button downs and really nice pants, and for the women, they have really great things as well, but they have really great options for those of you who are making that transition from, you know, school and now you're graduating and you want to find some items that are still unique and fun, but that allow you to step into a setting and know that you are dressed in a way that is professional still. I should also mention that they are having a sale right now. They have 30% off and 40% off, I think, regular priced items. And so if you are looking for some things, then definitely check that out. The next company that I want to introduce to you guys is one called Frank and Oak, and it is a company that was designed here in Montreal in 2012 by two friends, and they specialize in basics. They are a little bit on the expensive side again, but they have t-shirts, they have pants, they have socks, they have bombers, they have button downs. So they have quite a good selection again for those of you who want to start off your business casual wardrobe and maybe are also wanting to add some basics into your wardrobe as well. And so you can find some really nice jeans and t-shirts and sweaters and things like that. They design all of their clothing in the Mile End here in Montreal, which is pretty cool. And again, their clothing varies in price, and so you can find some items that definitely will probably fit into your budget. But again, they always have sales, and I think they have some pretty great sales in the summer in particular, and I think one in the winter. And so definitely just keep your eyes open for that. Next up are accessories, and the first accessory company that I want to talk to you guys about is one called Vitali, and it is actually unisex, but one of the things that's pretty cool is that they have really awesome industrial designed jewelry, and so you can find some really cool necklaces and rings, and you can find them also at Simons, which is another Canadian company. Their stuff is really, really cool, and so if you are, again, kind of a part of that urban streetwear type style, then it could complement some of the other brands pretty nicely by just throwing on one of their chokers or one of their rings and just adding that little extra edge to your outfit. The next accessory company that I want to speak about is one that I'm sure you guys know about, but perhaps did not know that it was Canadian. And it is one called Herschel, and it was created in 2009 in Vancouver. And so for those of you who are not familiar with Herschel, it is a company that specializes in backpacks in particular. And so you can find some fanny packs and some duffel bags, but also some beanies and hats. And so it's a pretty cool, again, urban type of company, and just complements, again, some of those other companies that I've mentioned to you guys today. Now, no outfit is complete without some shoes. And so the last accessory company that I want to share with you guys today is Aldo. And so for those of you who do not know, Aldo is a Canadian multinational company, and so started here in Montreal, but has since grown and expanded, which I think is always lovely to hear about when we learn about different local companies that have grown to an extent, of course, by support that has allowed them to then get into different markets. And I think that that is something that's pretty awesome. Of course, those of you who know about Aldo know that it's not strictly for men. It is unisex indeed, but they have some really great shoes. They have some sneakers and sandals and some loafers. And so again, for those of you who are in between that transition of student to young professional, Aldo is a really great place to find some of those items. But then again, those of you who are a little bit more on the urban side, but maybe don't necessarily want to go out and get your J's or your Adidas or what have you, Aldo again has some pretty nice sneakers. So definitely check them out if you don't already. Well, that's it, guys. I hope that you enjoyed this episode, and please let me know down in the comments below some of the brands that maybe you discovered today and are wanting to learn a little bit more about, some of the brands that maybe you're loving and that I didn't mention, so that those who see those comments can go ahead and check those brands out. And ultimately, I want to just remind us all that supporting does not mean buying. You can support by leaving reviews, you can support by liking their posts, you can support by following their accounts. And so hopefully this is just a little reminder and encouragement for us all on ways that we can love locally this year and beyond. See you guys so soon. Very literally, I'll see you tomorrow.